The topic is finding the directional derivative using limit definition. Alright, so let's do this example. Use the limit definition to find the directional derivative at the point 1, 3 in the direction of u equal the vector 1 half square root of 3 over 2. So we're looking for the functional derivative in the direction of the vector 1 half square root of 3, 2 at the point 1, 3. Now, if you look at the definition, it's a limit as h approach 0 of f of a plus h u1. Now, remember, my a happens to be 1, my b happens to be 3. So a is 1 plus h, and then the u1, this is going to be u1, and this is the u2. So what do we say? A plus h times u1, u1 is 1 half, right, comma, and then b is 3, plus h times u2, u2 is square root of 3, 2, minus f of ab is 1, 3, everything is divided by h. Now let's just rewrite this. This is going to be equal limit h approaches 0 of f of, that would be 1 plus h over 2, 1 plus h over 2, 3 plus square root of 3h over 2, minus f of 1, 3 divided by h. Now I need to plug in. I'm trying to find f of this point. This is my a and this is my b, the whole thing. So I need, or my x and y. So I need to plug all this into the x. What happened with my function? Use the limit definition to find blah, blah, blah. I need to give you a function. So f of xy, let me just write it here. Let f of xy to be equal to y squared plus xy. Right? So of course here we're assuming a function f of xy also in the definition. All right, so I need to plug all this into the x and all this into the y value. So that would be equal 3 plus square root of 3h, that's the y squared, plus x times y, 1 plus h over 2 times y, 3 plus square root of 3h over 2. This is just that part. Minus, well, f of 1 over 3, if you plug 1 into x, let me do it here. Y is 3, so 3 squared plus 1 times 3. That would be equal 9 plus 3, which is just 12, minus 12, all of that over h, and of course we need the limit as h approaches 0. Right, now it's all about just foiling. This is going to be equal limit as h approaches 0. If I foil this, 3 squared is 9, plus 2 times 3 times square root of 3h, this is just foiling, plus square root of 3 over 2 squared, plus more foiling, now foiling these, 1 times 3 is 3, plus square root of 3 over 2h, plus 3h over 2, plus h over 2 times square root of 3h over 2, all of that minus 12, this is 9. over h. Now let's see if we can simplify anything. This is going to be equal limit, or let's just FOIL it more. So this is going to be 9. This 2 goes with this 2. So this will be 3 square root of 3h. And if you square square root of 3, you get 3 over 4. So 3 over 4h squared plus 3. Plus square root of 3 over 2h plus 3 over 2h plus square root of 3 over 4h times h is h squared minus 12 over h. Now 9 plus 3 is 12, minus 12 is 0, so that will be cancelled. So this is going to be equal limit as h approaches 0. Now let me just factor that h that's going to be bothering me. So h factor 3 square root of 3 plus 3 over 4h plus square root of 3 over 2 plus 3 over 2 plus square root of 3 over 4h over h. We'll simplify that. And then plug, once we do that, well, let me do it in 2 steps. 3 square root of 3 plus 3 over 4h plus square root of 3 over 2 plus 3 over 2 plus square root of 3 4h. Now I'm going to plug a 0 into h. 0 go here and go there. 3 square root of 3 plus 3 over 4, 0, plus square root of 3, 2, plus 3 over 2, plus square root of 3 over 4 times 0. So this goes to 0, this goes to 0, and then the answer will be 3 square root of 3 plus square root of 3 over 2 plus 3 over 2. Yep, that's it. And then of course you can rewrite this as one number. Let's write everything over 2. So that would be 6 square root of 3 plus square root of 3 plus 3, which is 7 square root of 3 plus 3 over 2. And that would be your limit. And that's it for this example.